San Francisco is in the midst of a huge housing crisis. And entrepreneur Alvina Beck's proposed solution? A network of pods where you can rent a bunk bed in a shared space for $1,200 a month.
The whole concept of Podshare is like minimalist living and how to increase the density in small spaces. So the whole idea is like San Francisco and Los Angeles has really unaffordable housing. Why? Because there's a low supply and a high demand. But if the demand and supply were more equal, then the price would be better. So these are the pods that we share. This is the San Francisco pod share. And so here it's 30 days or more, but at the other locations, you could do by night, by week, or by month. And at this location, we have 16 pods all open. It's co-ed, it's custom built. And there's amenities like that flat screen, a nightlight, personal outlets, memory foam mattress, jersey knit sheets, and we'll wash the sheets for you. You can wash them yourself, whichever you want. Podshare is a product of high rents, and our solution is the sharing economy. So basically, we can't make the prices. We just live by them like anybody else.
Average rents in San Francisco have reached over $3,600, and landlords often charge first and last month rent, plus security deposit, which puts the cost of moving in at around $10,000. The sharing or renting economy is very popular with millennials. Companies like Zipcar, Uber, and WeWork make it really easy to not actually own things like cars and workspaces.
My name is Stephen T. Johnson. I'm 27. I've been staying in Podshare. My very first time was February of 2018. And the longest time has been current. I believe I've been here about 5 months. I wish I could rent everything. Like, I wish Chipotle had a pay for the month and then you just show up whenever you want and pick up your food. Right now, I rent everything that I can. So examples would be like scooters, office space, gym membership. I don't even have a backpack. I don't have a suitcase. I don't need those things. I have an iPhone, a pair of headphones, an iPhone charger, an outfit. So the sharing economy to me at its best is when you're able to do things during the day to day that you would normally do if you own those things. So whether it be a car, or cooking, or living, all of those things, but being able to rent them rather than own them.
Alvina's Podshare model has spread across LA. She now has 5 locations where members can stay in any pod at any location they like. This is her first in San Francisco, but she hopes to expand. However, she is getting some pushback from city officials and residents.
So a single family home in San Francisco only allows for 6 people. That's a single family of non-related. So technically, I'm only supposed to have 6 people, which I do. 6 people for over 30 days. With building this model out, my intention is to show the city, which we have in our permit processing, which we're in, is to say, hey, this is what a 16-person group housing scenario would look like. It's only been a month that we're here, that's what's funny, despite being a 7-year-old company, and we've actually got reported 3 times. We've got complaints against us for violations for increased density. So they're saying there's bunk beds in here because their pictures are up on the internet, and they're saying they're housing too many people in there.
Alvina is waiting to see if the city will let her house more than 6 people. What do you think? Is this a good housing solution for cities? Let us know in the comments below.